Anybody have any questions about anything that we've discussed, Roy?
Eventually, will you have tips out on how to handle the judge?
How to handle him? Next week, I'll do something.
Okay.
How to handle the judge. Good. I'll do that, like looking him in the eye.
Especially like when he says, this is my court.
Oh, there you go.
Well, I had that happen to me a couple times. This is my court and I'll do what I want to do.
Oh, I don't get that.
Yeah, there you go.
Because Young filed an affidavit of disqualification and got his judge removed off his case.
Good. Good. Well, I'll say a couple things and then we will get ice cream. This country needs to understand what this country is. And, you know, we've been told it's the fields of wheat and from shore to shining shore, you know, and it's the iron fields and the oil wells and it's the hardworking people and it's all these things they tell us that when you hear the music, you know, America. But you see what America really is? It's a mechanism. It's a machine. Every government's a machine, if you think about it. And the difference between this machine and the other machines, the way it was conceived, was that we would have a machine that is built on the premise that the rights of the people do not derive from the largesse of the government. Now you all know that, don't you? You knew that before I said it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, but it needs to be trumpeted from the housetops. Because the people don't, maybe they hear it and oh yeah, and they forget about it. Now you have the idiots that want to take God out of government.
We will be closing the internet computers in 5 minutes. The library itself will be closing in 20 minutes. And please bring all materials to the checkout counters at this time.
And if they succeed, it will be because, and forgive me, I'm going to go ahead and say this, and walk out if you want. Religionists. Can I use that word? Religionists?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I mean, Jesus talked about religionists, didn't he?
Yeah, he did.
They're the people that plotted to murder him, aren't they? Mm-hmm. He talked about hirelings, too, didn't he?
What was it?
John chapter 10, if you want to look it up.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, religionists, who want us to think that God belongs to us. See, God only belongs to the Christians. But you see, even Jesus said, the Father. Just the Father that Jesus talked about, now just give me a minute, is the same as the Great Spirit of the Plains Indian. Does anybody here want to disagree with me? The God, the Father, forget that word God, because God's, G-O-D is not the name of God. The Father that Jesus talked about is the same Allah that the Islamic people see. And it's the Tao of the Taoists, you see. Every culture, every people knows that somehow, in a way that nobody really understands and only fools pretend to understand, there is something that's keeping all this together. And the thing that we ought to make up our minds, you want a lawsuit, there's a lawsuit, is that add another O to the word.
Good.
Good. You see, we trust that doing good will bring us good. We trust in God. That there is something that we don't understand that rewards doing right. And sometimes you have to get very, very, very old before you realize that, and you make a lot of stupid mistakes when you're young. But we've got a nation that's 200 years old, and it's being very foolish because of the religionists who have painted God into their corner. Am I right? Now, here's the problem, Jurisdictionary chapter. If you let them take God out, then your rights derive from the largesse of the oligarchy that happens to be in power at the moment. Mm-hmm. And that's not what Dick died for. You see, you've got a really important job to do here. It goes way beyond winning lawsuits. It's about giving the power to the people to make things right again. And the only way they're going to be able to do that is that, that knowledge, part of that knowledge, is understanding how does the machine work and what do we have to do to keep it working properly. And that's not working properly now. How do we get it to work the way it's supposed to work? What does it look like when it's working? And it is a nation under God, whatever God might be. But most of us are wise enough, and I think even those people, those atheist people, should hopefully be wise enough to think that this nation needs to be doing good. We need not to be torturing prisoners. We need not to be doing bad things and thinking, oh, well, you know, the ends justify the means. That is evil. So, we give the power to the people by teaching them how to command the courts. And then we give the people these principles. It has to go hand in hand. As I was saying to Michael, there are two columns on the porch of Solomon, of Solomon's temple. Anybody here know anything about Solomon's temple?
About that? A little bit.
Okay, some of you do. Bit. Anybody here know Hiram Abiff?
No.
Okay. Anyway, there's Jachin and Boaz. Two things. So as you go forward with your group, action is in one hand. But principles is in the other. Don't lose these. Because if you lose these, all of this will ultimately be corrupted and you will be wasting your time. You might as well go play golf. But if you keep the principles there, that what's right and true and good and perfect and just and honorable, and you always strive for those things and use these rules, the rule of law, and the principles and practices and the power of due process that was purchased for you by the blood of wonderful people, you can't go wrong. You cannot fail. And God is on your side.
Just put
the extra O in there.
Dr. Graves, from a historical perspective, when did it go wrong? Or when was it created that it was working right? And at what point in time did it go wrong?
It never worked right. We had slavery when the whole thing began. We had slaves. We had people. We had women didn't vote until what? 1921.
1923.
Women were being. I mean, horrible things. Just 20 years before I was born. Horrible things. But what I want to get you to see is that in some ways things are getting better, but in other ways they're getting worse.
The internet computers are now closed. Oh, the library itself will be closing in
14
minutes.
Ron Paul, when he was finally, I guess, to some degree giving up, right? He said, now it's up to the people. You remember, some of you got that email, right? Now it's up to the people. But what he didn't do, and I beg people that knew him to connect me with him, what he has not done yet is okay, what do we do? Where's the power? He didn't give them the power because he still, bless his heart, he's still lost in the idea that politics, getting the right man in power, is the answer. Getting the right man in power doesn't change anything.
That's right.
It's just another puppet playing to the strings of whoever's the oligarchy, the money, the people.
That's right.
The people in this country have, just imagine, if everybody in this country woke up tomorrow morning and they know what I know, and they were wise enough to come together and say, we're not going to take it anymore. Sorry. We're not taking it anymore. We have got children and grandchildren, and they are going to live in a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful place that's going to set an example for the entire world, and it's called America. But it wasn't right at the beginning. I'm kind of cheating. I think part of it, this is just me personally, speaking as a man. Something happened in World War I. You can actually read case law up until around 1911 in there. Something happened. World War I was the most horrible, of course the Civil War was horrible, but it was gunpowder and bayonets and hand-to-hand. The World War I was poison gas and mechanized things. We never had those things before. It was terrible. And I think that something happened. If you ever write this down, Washington's vision. I want everyone, if you don't know it, sir, read it. It States, just put Washington's vision, Google, and read it.
You'll find it. It's interesting.
That, I think that happened to us. I think we went insane. And then we dropped the bomb. You see? People say, what had to be done? Well, okay, it had to be done. But it was wrong. And I think we turned into ourselves. It was wrong. Women and children and babies and people in nursing and hospitals were turned to ashes. And we knew it was wrong, but we did it, but it had to be done, and we got all confused. And if you look at the case law, see, I've read all thousands and thousands. If you study the history of case law, if you ever had time, and, you know, who does? You see there are changes. And social science.
The library will close in 10 minutes. Please bring all materials to the checkout counters at this time.
I'll be done in a minute. Social science began to replace justice. What was expedient began to replace what's right. And we all went along with it. Because we didn't know how to, number one, we didn't know how to change it. And number two, we were not unified. This may not be the end all and be all, but it's something about which all of you can agree. We're not talking about whether we should be on the gold standard, or whether the banks are generating money out of air. We're not talking about things about which people can disagree. Anybody that knows what you talk about here at Jurisdictionary can't disagree with us. Because it's 100%. And that people need something to believe in. And I think that we went insane. And then the 60s. You know? Four Dead in Ohio. You remember that song? Are you too young for that?
Kent State.
Mm-hmm. I hear the drums. I was right here, wasn't it? Kent State. It's in Ohio.
Kent State. Yes.
Close to Akron.
Yeah. Something was wrong. And the people just turned into themselves, and they turned into, you know, money and getting a bigger SUV and having fancier clothes than my neighbor. And it all just kind of accelerated. And we've lost sight of good. We've got to find that again. And then we've got to work hard to restore it. Because it won't restore itself. You know, I'll bet you $1,000 if I flip that switch. The darkness has no choice but to fill the room.
The library will be closing in 10 minutes.
Yes, ma'am, we heard the announcement, but thank you very much.
Okay. We only got about another 30 minutes, we'll be done.
If I could just share that with you, because it just excites me, that, and I really appreciate that you came, and I love to talk, and I could never stop with you. The fun thing about light, you know, God is light, God is truth, God is good, God is love. But the fun thing about light is, light can dispel darkness. Darkness cannot dispel light. So don't give up. The darkness has no power. Don't pay attention to what other people say. Screw them. Think for yourselves. Darkness has no power. Light has power. But when you turn it off, think about it this. Darkness has no choice. Turn off the light, it will come in. Mm-hmm. Has no choice. So if you love your children, work for justice.
Thank you.
Will you promote the mission? Will you work for this? Will you teach people? Thanks. Thank I have you. Some of these if you want them.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Ice cream.
Ice cream.